Anna. Is it okay if I'm right behind you, Anna? Thank you. Okay.
Motivating and inspiring our younger peers. And of course, our musicians in the middle school get to do both. I want to thank the East Hartford Public Schools Board of Education and Superintendent Nate Quinnell and Assistant Superintendents Amber Manzini and Samita Ritchie for their ongoing support of arts education in East Hartford Public Schools. I also want to thank everyone who has made this event possible, central office and school administrators, the teachers, and families. Give yourselves a round of applause. And now, without further ado, I'd like to introduce the grade 3 string ensemble. Third graders are introduced to the violin, viola, and cello through weekly half-hour group lessons using a modified Suzuki approach. Songs are played from memory, allowing students to concentrate on the fundamentals of good technique. Their teachers are Mr. Irwin James and Ms. Dana Zacamano. Tonight they're being conducted by Mr. James with accompaniment by Nathaniel Baker. Students will be playing well-known children's songs, Hot Cross Buns, Mary Had a Little Lamb, and Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. And now, the third grade strings.
Thank you.
they've only been playing since September. Outstanding. I would just like to take a moment to let you know that at the end of the concert, we have a special dismissal procedure, which we'll let you know about at the end. So at the conclusion, after the grand finale, we'll ask all of you to stay in your seats and we'll send the kids back to you by room so that it'll be easier to find out. The junior orchestra is made up of students in fourth and fifth grade who have been playing anywhere from 1 to 3 years on the violin, viola, and cello. Also, the upright string bass becomes an option at this time for the taller grade 4 and up students. In fourth grade, students start to learn to read music. The first year of note reading allows students to play in the elementary string orchestra. Many of the second and third year players participated in Interel this year. We would like to honor some of our exemplary orchestra students who participated in various programs throughout the year. First, would the Interel students please stand and be recognized? Thank you. And next, those who were selected for the CMEA Honors Orchestra, please stand. There was one student who performed in the Eastern Region Orchestra at the high school level. Julia Brown, please stand. The junior orchestra will be playing Theme and Variation on London Bridge and Take a Swing at This, both composed by Otto Woods. Tonight, they're being conducted by Mr. Irvin James and Ms. Dana Zachman. Thank you. And next we'll be moving on to our middle school portion of the evening. Sunset Ridge School is an IB candidate school with a vibrant arts and music program. The Sunset Ridge Orchestra meets every other day for ensemble rehearsals. Students are taught by Rebecca Corcoran. The selection being performed by the Sunset Orchestra is Rhythms of Africa by S.H. Newbold. I think you will enjoy this piece, which includes body percussion performed by the string players as well. Thank you.
Thank you.
And next you'll be hearing the lead part for our high school orchestra. And someday we hope that all of our younger students will be in the high school orchestra as well. The high school orchestra meets daily during the last period of the day. This is a great way for the students to end their school day. They get to express themselves musically and collaboratively with a supportive friend group to work towards the common goal. These students also stay after school 3 times per quarter to work in small groups with a student leader to better prepare for our rehearsals. The high school orchestra is also conducted by Miss Anna Lasley. They will be playing the first movement of the concerto for two violins by Jaya Spott and featuring 2 soloists who also just happen to be in the top 10 of their graduating senior class. Thomas Marinato and April Kinsley. That's a pretty outstanding honor, and it's based on their academic GPA. So let's hear it once again for top 10, Thomas and Marinato. And now, without further ado, the East Hartford High School Orchestra.
Thank you. the word to use is, but it's really a phenomenal thing where out of 10 graduating students from my orchestra, 6 of them are graduating in the top 20, not 20%, the top 20 of their graduating class, and 2 of them are in fact in the top 10 of their graduating class. So, yeah, have a round of applause. I just wanted to also point out how humble these students are. You know, a lot of students, when they get that, no, you're in the top 20, they tell all their friends, not my students. I found out sort of like very late in the game because they're just so humble. And because of that, I'm going to respect that, and I'm not going to have them stand up because I think that they're all special. And I just wanted to, before I present them to come on up here to get their rose, I just wanted to just tell you that it's in the program. All of them have written about where they're going and what they've done while they were here, but just as a little synopsis, where they're going. We have students that are going to be attending Manchester Community College, Southern Connecticut State University, Eastern Connecticut State University, my alma mater, University of Connecticut, and we also have a student attending Emmanuel College in Boston, and I think I hit them all, and they're going to be studying lots of varying different subjects. We have students that are going to be studying writing and literature, psychology, actuarial science. They're going to make a lot of money. Sociology. We have a pre-med student, sociology, health sciences, and political science. It's really astonishing, and I hope and I really believe that they will continue either to be music citizens of the world by attending performances, and I really hope that they're going to be performing in their schools and eventually community orchestras, or who knows, maybe a professional orchestra along the way. So I'm so proud of them. I'm going to miss them terribly. Many of them are like my right hand in this class. I have students that, I have one student in particular, I will not embarrass him, but since he's been in seventh grade, he's always set my watch. The time changed, so I don't know what I'll do next year. I'm going to have to find someone else to do that. And again, right hand with technology, my music librarian, who's been the best. He's been our librarian for about 3 or 4 years. I could go on and on. I won't because we have a lot of music to do, but I just wanted to present our graduating seniors. So when I say your name, seniors, if you could come on up here and get your rose, and then maybe this is a great moment for a picture of mom and dad if you'd like. So without any further ado, in no particular order, Nadell Kendall. Thank you. Brianna Sieza.
Thank you.
also like to introduce a student conductor for the high school orchestra, Ms. Jasmine Ayala. very much. I think it would be remiss if we didn't recognize the music teachers that make this all possible. So let's have a round of applause for Miss Anna Leslie. I'd also like to thank the East Hartford Public School Board of Education and Superintendent Nate Quinnell for once again making this program possible. Thank you. We ask that you all stay seated, and we'd like to begin with sending our third grade students to the back gym, and they will come back out here to meet you in the gym. So third grade.